City in the Pacific invites you and your family to come away with us to the sea. Convenient daily departures by sea train and skylift.
Mesa Verde, the most advanced desert reclamation complex in the Western Hemisphere, invites you to explore its wide range of career possibilities. Maglev Express service to Mesa Verde leaves every 30 minutes.
Brava Centauri, newest of the exciting Centauri series of space stations, offers remarkably rewarding opportunities in Earth support vocations. Come up to Brava. Space shuttles depart daily.
My wife's right. Wait till you see the new towns of tomorrow. Desert farms and floating cities, even colonies in space. But you know, this isn't exactly the first time anyone's tried to make this trip. People have been dreaming about the future for centuries. Well, here's the stuff dreams were made of several hundred years ago. Yep, it's always fun looking back at tomorrow. Come on, I'll show you what I mean. There's the grand old man himself, Jules Verne. This is the way a moonshot looked to him back in the late 1800s. Old Uncle Jules may not have had all the answers, but he had the right idea.
He was just a little ahead of his time.
You know, people have painted some pretty fantastic views of the future.
And some pretty mixed up ones, too.
It's always been just around the corner.
Shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow. And tomorrow, just a dream away. Man has a dream, and that's the start. He follows his dream with mind and heart. And when it becomes a reality, it's a dream come true for you and me. So there's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, just a dream away. Man has a dream that that's the start.
Quit stalling, get back to work. Go on.
Say, we're just in time for the matinee.
Yeah, looking back at tomorrow through the movies of yesteryear.
No driving responsibility. Family relax together. En route business conferences are conducted by television. Entering the city, the family separates. Father to his office, mother and son to the shopping center. These new forms of vehicles will bring about special purposes.
Look, the future from the 50s.
A bit far out, don't you think?
I guess so. But we always thought the future would be kind of fun.
I suppose people have always dreamed of the future. We sure do.
The only difference is that today, with what we know and what we're learning to do, we really can bring our dreams to life. It takes a lot of work, but the truth is, if we can dream it, we can do it.
Tomorrow's horizons are here, today.
Crystals, inspired by nature, now engineered by man, for an ever-growing role in microelectronics. The world of liquid space. Oceans of minerals and food ready to fuel tomorrow's needs. The DNA chain. Life's molecular blueprint. Decoding its secrets is leading us to dramatically improved health. The sun. Today we're learning ways to harness its limitless energy. In space, habitats where people live and work. This is no distant dream. We're at the threshold now. A computerized view of Earth. Landsat photography, providing vital data on agriculture, resources, and ecological concerns. The cityscape. A living tribute to our richest resource, people. Here's a new kind of cityscape, the microprocessor, an entire computer on a tiny silicon chip. What you've just seen are the building blocks for the future up ahead. And while it may look fantastic, remember, it's all possible.
That's right.
And we ought to know. We live there. Come on, take a look at 21st century living. On land and sea and even out in space. But let's start off at our place.
Underwater.
judgment. Floating cities, they're amazing. I mean, whole new industries have developed in them and under them. Mariculture, all sorts of marine mining, fuels, energy.
And fun. Remember fun?
I'm serious.
Well, so am I. Floating cities have opened up whole new ways for people to enjoy their lives, as well as their work.
There's always been something sort of mysterious about our oceans. We knew they were filled with valuable gifts for us.
Yeah, water and seaweed.
Very funny. But seawater has become an excellent source of energy, as well as being valuable for desert irrigation. And kelp.
Seaweed.
Kelp is a tremendous source of low-cost fuel. Oh, we found lots of good things under our oceans.
And don't forget space. We found lots of good things out there, too.
Space colonies are out of this world. Let's take a quick look around. Our son and his family wouldn't live anywhere else. Hey, maybe you and I ought to move up here.
Oh, what a wonderful idea.
Now there's my speed. Sports and exercise in zero gravity.
It looks like fun.
It is once you get the hang of it.
Hey, Mom! Mom!
What is it, Tommy?
Look, Mom, I'm flying! Why don't you try?
I don't know what I'm going to do with you. Don't let go of Napoleon. We don't want to lose him.
Hey, Mom, what if he just floats away?
Mom.
Hey, Mom, what if I just float away?
Then your father will get you as soon as he manages to get your shoe.
Materials from space for all kinds of industries back on Earth. And that's...
Uh-oh. We gotta run.
Time for our grandson's party?
Uh-huh.
We'll catch up to you later.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
almost back from the future.
Oh, it went by so quickly.
Yes, but one of the nice things about traveling into the future is that the journey's just beginning.
That's right.
And I'll tell you something. If we can dream it, we really can do it. And that's the most exciting part.
Us, thanks for exploring horizons. Now, please take small children by the hand and watch your step onto the moving belt. The belt and your vehicle are traveling at equal speed.
Thank you.